In the beginning, you hire somebody because of their work. I saw his work. It was fantastic. It was really beautiful. And met him. He was a very sweet guy, easy to get along with. And with the combination of those things, I said, let's go. I think Ralph's contribution to the Star Wars world is incalculable. It's just, you know, him bringing the characters that I described with words to life and visuals, to be able to see what they look like, was a very key component in being able to put the whole story together, because it's one thing to describe things, and then it's one thing to actually be able to hold a picture up. And the pictures were so accurate in terms of what I wanted that it was very easy then, as I kept going on, and say, this is what I want the Death Star to look like. This is what I want the desert to look like. This is what I want, you know. So a lot of those things were crucial in, the development. The other person who was involved in that was John Barry, who would go out and find the homestead and you know, then Ralph would do a drawing of it. And so he even helped the art department visualize exactly what it is what we were working with.
His reproductions of his artwork were all over ILM. I think he did originally something like 12 or 13, 14 paintings to help convince the studios that George was doing a project that they wanted to do, so they could visually see it rather than just hear the story.
Well, seeing the images that Ralph had done and reading the script, seeing the type of work we had to do on the show, it seemed pretty impossible to get done in the time frame we had. The artwork Ralph had done was beyond like anything I'd seen before, because it encompassed so many different things, you know, landscapes and space scenes and character designs, you know, Vader and stuff. It was just awesome.
I remember going in to have our first meeting and seeing his artwork on this, and Phil and I just kind of going off like popcorn of what that suggested we might be able to do for these additional Cantina characters and what the whole thing might be like. So he was just like a compass, a really like a gold compass that just got you really pumped up about what you're going to be part of, and got your creative juices going about what you might be able to do as a leaping off point from his illustrations.
And on the wall, I'll never forget this, was Ralph's artwork that he had done for Empire. And it was beyond anything that was in Star Wars. It was just like the biggest, you know, hook that anybody could have done to grab me to come up here. Everything was just phenomenal. You know, the Walker battle with the snow speeders, and there was just so many. The Yoda character, like, where did this guy come from? You know, and there was this wonderful flying manta ray that didn't make it in the movie that I thought would be a great thing to do around the Cloud City sequence. But just all this great artwork, and I said, okay, I'm coming. I'm moving. And so he had a real influence on getting me to make the move, was that artwork. Just like George used the artwork to inspire people to give him money, it also worked in my case to inspire me to move 400 miles away.
You know, amazed and excited would probably be good words when you came across new work by Ralph. The challenge was there all the time. You know, it never felt unchallenged. ILM was not that kind of place.
I remember watching him and Mike Pangrazio do the big psych background for the Walker sequence, and everybody on that had so many hats, and we were all rushing around, but you just couldn't help but stop because they were pretty good size pieces. And you'd go by one day, and they're laying it out and sketching in the thing, and you'd come back a few hours later, oh, there's more, and you'd watch them work, and it was magic. It was just this stuff coming right out of his hands.
Well, somehow Ralph's work was not just a concept of something, it was like a shot. He obviously understood cameras and lenses and perspectives and the right angle and the right lighting to get it. And then on top of that, you've got the characters or the landscapes or settings he's created and put them all together in one essentially shot that you can put together for a movie. Often concept art is literally like an architectural view in color, though, from a side looking at something and maybe two or three different angles. But Ralph's really were very emotional. And you could understand what he was getting at. Everything looked like it had a backstory to it. Everything looked like it had actually been used, even though it was painting. You could tell that this guy had life experiences, knew how to put stuff in it. And I'm sure, George was very much in there directing him a lot of the time, but Ralph, I'm sure, had a lot to do with it. And when George saw what he wanted, he would always say, okay, look at Ralph's art, that's what I want.
Before George Lucas and Ralph McQuarrie, there's nobody like these guys, I don't think, that came up with an idea of the whole idea of aging a universe or a look of a world where it's the patina is aged, the spaceships are not clean and squeaky fresh coming out of the transportation coordination area. The concepts that they came up with were brilliant. Just brilliant. I mean, it helped everybody all the way up and down, whether you're a model maker or a photographer or a costumer. They broke ground, new ground that nobody else at that point in time had. I mean, you look back even on the work at this point, it holds up. And there are lots of movies and lots of pieces of art that don't hold up when you look back 5 years. Well, we're talking about shots and designs and things 25, 30 years or more that they hold up as beautifully now as they did then. Now that's genius.